Hello guys, this is Leo the Wise, giving to all men, their needed uprise.
Second and last part of the video about marriage is fraud from MGTOW.com. Therefore, there were many things which constituted fault. Adultery, alcoholism, mental insanity, cruelty, physical abusiveness amongst a host of others all constituted fault. If you were at fault, you could expect to lose your rights as set forth in the contract. But even so, if there was no fault and you still wanted to leave, no one was stopping you. You were not put in jail for leaving, but you were found to be at fault for abandonment, and therefore lost all of your rights as set forward in the contract, and you would be liable for any damages caused by your fault. It seems fair to me. All contracts are set forth in this manner. That is why they are contracts. A contract says that if you behave in such and such manner and don't deviate out of that behavior, you will be compensated with a guarantee of this and this behavior from the other party. Step out of these guidelines and you will be legally liable. Stay within them and your rights will be guaranteed. But, in the 1970s, the ever-wise feminists declared that it was far too difficult to find fault in people's complex personal relationships, and therefore no-fault divorce was implemented, again with the aid of the heavy hand of the courts. Odd, isn't it? They have no troubles at all finding fault in cases of domestic violence. So what have we got left here? We have a fraudulent contract masquerading as marriage. What was originally based on a woman selling a man the ability to have his own children and taking his surplus labor as payment, has become a woman having children of her own and still taking a man's surplus labor as payment for that which she is not selling. That is fraud. If you go to a car dealership and buy a shiny new car, you might sign on the dotted line and agree to make payments for the next 5 years, but it is implied in the contract that you own the car. The dealership cannot decide 6 months later that they want the car back, show up at your house, and just take it. And certainly they cannot force you to make the next 54 payments on it if they take it away from you with no breach of contract on your part. It is your property and they have no right to it. To suggest otherwise would be to suggest you signed a fraudulent contract. To suggest that you would still have to pay for gas, maintenance, and insurance after they sell it to someone else because it is in the best interests of the car is to suggest an insanely fraudulent contract. Yup. But this is what we are left with in the marriage contract. The man gets none of the property or rights which the contract was originally based upon, but the vendor still has the right to make you into this. Hi-ah, move it, you strong ox, bellows the ex-wife. You are divorced now with no legal rights to what you thought you paid for. So start pulling this plow. No more lazing around for you, slave. My children and I own your labor. You own nothing. Marriage should be outlawed. Marriage is fraud. Do not enter into fraudulent contracts. Nope. Let the little ladies and their children go back to living like this. Have nothing to do with them. Do not oppress them with marriage. Do not oppress them by allowing them to live in your nice home. Do not have sex with them. All sex is rape. Don't you know? Do not donate sperm. That now makes you liable to be a slave too. Again, make sure you do not oppress one single one of them with marriage. Do you hate women or something? Why would you want to oppress one of them with marriage, you misogynist? Put down that bride magazine, mister. We know what you are thinking. Now move on and think more wholesome thoughts. Do not burden a single one of them with a child. Women can stand kids and would like to have nothing to do with them. And, most certainly, don't pay anyone for a product they have no intention of actually selling to you. Do not feel you are obligated to work like a fool to pay taxes which support the herd of single and divorced mothers along with their feral children. You are not responsible to pay for someone else's property. You don't owe the herd anything. They don't even want you to be part of the herd. You are not responsible to be an economic performer who props up herd living with your labor while receiving nothing in return except a pat on the head along with a good boy. There are plenty of monogenes who will prop up the herd until it can be propped up anymore. Let them work like dolts in an unsustainable system for someone else's benefit then. Give them as few tax dollars as possible. Men should go back to only expending 20-30% of their labor ability, so they can return to living like this. Why in the hell would you want to oppress one of those tricksters with patriarchy? Why even bother with a cow that does and give milk, let alone pay for one? Don't marry. It lowers divorce rates and cuts back on fraud.
And that is it for now. If this content was entertaining and interested you, please share, like, and subscribe to this channel. I am the Swan, leading men till dawn, and even beyond. Thanks for the audience.